नमस्कार, मैं हूं देवांजलि मोइत्रा। पुलवामा हमले के बाद से ही आतंकवाद को लेकर पाकिस्तान की चौतरफा आलोचना होने लगी और अभी भी जारी है। आतंकवाद को लेकर दुनिया के सभी देश पाकिस्तान की सख्त आलोचना कर रहे हैं। पाकिस्तान को हिदायत भी दे रहे हैं कि पाक अपने यहां से आतंकवाद को खत्म करे, वरना इसका परिणाम बुरा होगा। आतंकवाद ही था कि पाकिस्तान पर बिजली की तरह टूट पड़ा भारत और सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक किया। उसके बाद FATF ने आतंकवाद की वजह से पाक पर बैन लगाया। आतंकवाद को लेकर पूरी दुनिया में पाक की थू थू हो रही है और आज की डेट में पाकिस्तान विश्व बिरादरी के सामने अकेला पड़ गया है। लेकिन अभी भी पाकिस्तान को झटके पे झटका लग रहा है। अब नए मामले में आतंक के पनाहगार देश पाकिस्तान को दो झटके लगे और ये दोनों झटके उसके आका अमेरिका की तरफ से आए। पाक के आका अमेरिका ने सबसे पहले संयुक्त राष्ट्र में टेरर फंडिंग का प्रस्ताव पेश किया। उसके बाद आका ने अपनी संसद में भी आतंकवाद के खिलाफ प्रस्ताव पेश किया। अमेरिकी संसद में कांग्रेस सांसद स्कॉट पेरी ने पाकिस्तान में मौजूद आतंकियों के खिलाफ कार्रवाई की मांग करने का एक प्रस्ताव पेश किया। प्रस्ताव पेश करते हुए उन्होंने कहा कि बहुत हो चुका है, अब पाकिस्तान सरकार को जवाबदेह ठहराए जाने का समय आ गया है। उन्होंने आगे कहा कि दक्षिण एशिया में मौजूद आतंकियों को जड़ से खत्म करने की अमेरिका की कोशिशों के बावजूद पाकिस्तान के पास आतंकवादियों और आतंकी समूहों के प्रति सहानुभूति रखने का लंबा इतिहास रहा है और आतंकी घटनाओं का खामियाजा निर्दोष लोगों को अपनी जान गंवा कर चुकाना पड़ रहा है। इसलिए अब समय आ गया है कि आतंकवाद को खत्म किया जाए और आतंकवाद को खत्म करने के लिए इससे अच्छा समय नहीं होगा। आपको मालूम हो कि 14 फरवरी को CRPF के काफिले पर जैश के आत्मघाती हमलावर ने हमला किया था, जिसमें 40 जवान शहीद हो गए थे। वहीं अमेरिका के इस प्रस्ताव की भारत ने जमकर तारीफ की है। भारत ने पाकिस्तान का नाम लिए बिना कहा कि कुछ देश है जो बार बार मना करने के बाद भी गलत कामों में लिप्त रहते हैं। भारत के संयुक्त राष्ट्र संघ में स्थायी प्रतिनिधि सैयद अकबरुद्दीन ने कहा कि वित्तीय कार्यवाही कार्यबल वैश्विक मानदंडों की स्थापना करने में अहम भूमिका निभाता है। अकबरुद्दीन ने आगे कहा कि जो राज्य आतंकवादियों के समर्थक हैं, वो लगातार उनके पक्ष में किए अपने कार्यों को न्यायसंगत सिद्ध करने के बहाने बनाते रहे हैं। जो भी हो, भारत की तकलीफ देखकर आज दुनिया आतंकवाद से लड़ने के लिए भारत के कदम से कदम मिला के चल रहा है। ये बात अमेरिका के संसद में पेश हुई रिपोर्ट से कही जा सकती है।
Then, by his creative power, he made all mortal beings. From that one light, the entire world came into being. So who is good and who is bad? Your Highness and Excellencies, India has always embraced and found it easy to embrace pluralism, since it is embedded in the oldest Sanskrit religious text, the Rig Veda, and I quote, Ekam Sadvipra Bahudha Vadanti, which means, God is one, but learned men describe him in many ways. Our great philosopher Swami Vivekananda said that this phrase from the Rig Veda has given the theme to all subsequent thoughts to India, and one that will be the theme of the whole world of religions. Your Highness and Excellencies, this is not a clash of civilizations or cultures, but a contest of ideas and ideals. As Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi has often said, it is a struggle between the values of humanism and the forces of inhumanity. Your Highness and Excellencies, if we want to save the humanity, then we must tell the states who provide shelter and funding to the terrorists to dismantle the infrastructure of the terrorist camps and stop providing funding and shelter to the terror organizations based in that country. At the same time, I would like to say that this menace cannot be fought only through military, intelligence, or diplomatic means. It is also a battle that must be won through the strength of our values and the real message of religions. This is a task that states, societies, sages, scholars, spiritual leaders, and families must pursue through personal contacts and on social media. And for this, faiths must speak to faiths. Cultures must engage with cultures. Communities must build bridges, not erect walls. The youth must shape the future not destroy lives. Your Highness and Excellencies, I'm particularly pleased to participate in a conference whose theme is a roadmap for prosperity and development. However, I may enter a caveat. The young are not going to be content with only roadmaps. They want roads as well. They also want them to be built fast. It must be our common objective to ensure that we leave them a world that is infinitely better in terms of equitable economic growth and social justice than the one we inherited. That is the mission which has brought us together in Abu Dhabi, a city that has matured into a landmark of Asia and the world. Your Highness and Excellencies, India is the world's third largest economy on purchasing power parity and is the fastest growing one. We are prepared to share our market, resources, opportunities and skills with our partners. We will do what we can within our capacity to ensure that the path to development remains open to all and the global trade regime is open, stable and fair. Your Highness and Excellencies, at 50, Organization of Islamic States is making a new beginning. The choices you make, the directions you set, will have a profound impact on humanity. The OIC has a huge responsibility and a great opportunity to lift humanity to a higher level of peace and prosperity, and to make this planet a better place, not just for your people, but for the rest of the world. And we will work with you to spread the true meaning and mission of all religions, promote respect for and between faiths, counter the language of hate with the message of harmony, advocate moderation over extremism and pluralism over exclusion, inspire youth to the path of service, then of destruction, build bridge of understanding and reduce barriers across cultures and religions. Your Highness and Excellencies, the late President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, popularly referred to as the People's President, said, and I quote, "Where there is righteousness in the heart, there is beauty in the character. When there is beauty in the character, there is harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there is order in the nation. When there is order in the nation, there is peace in the world." Your Highness and Excellencies, I come from the land of Mahatma Gandhi, where every prayer ends with the call for Shanti, that is peace for all. I convey our best wishes, our support, and our solidarity in your quest for stability, peace, harmony, economic growth, and prosperity for your people and the world. Thank you. Shukran.
أشكر ضيفة الشرف معالي سوشما سواراج وزير خارجية جمهورية الهند على هذه الكلمة.
Then by his creative power he made all mortal beings. From that one light the entire world came into being. So who is good and who is bad? Your Highness and Excellencies, India has always embraced and found it easy to embrace pluralism since it is embedded in the oldest Sanskrit religious text, the Rig Veda, and I quote, "Ekam sadvipra bahudha vadanti," which means, God is one, but learned men describe him in many ways. Our great philosopher Swami Vivekananda said that this phrase from the Rig Veda has given the theme to all subsequent thoughts to India, and one that will be the theme of the whole world of religions. Your Highness and Excellencies, this is not a clash of civilizations or cultures, but a contest of ideas and ideals. As Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi has often said, it is a struggle between the values of humanism and the forces of inhumanity. Your Highness and Excellencies, if we want to save the humanity, then we must tell the states who provide shelter and funding to the terrorists to dismantle the infrastructure of their terrorist camps and stop providing funding and shelter to the terror organizations based in that country. At the same time, I would like to say that this menace cannot be fought only through military, intelligence, or diplomatic means. It is also a battle that must be won through the strengths of our values and the real message of religions. This is a task that states, societies, sages, scholars, spiritual leaders and families must pursue through personal contacts and on social media. And for this, faiths must speak to faiths. Cultures must engage with cultures. Communities must build bridges, not erect walls. The youth must shape the future, not destroy lives. Your Highness and Excellencies, I'm particularly pleased to participate in a conference whose theme is a roadmap for prosperity and development. However, I may enter a caveat.